While the discernment process involved concrete analytical questioning of the progress of all former processes, the solidarity economy involves steps towards rethinking all areas of society in the economy without gender polarization. It brings together and integrates all feminist transformation processes in an effort to make businesses, the economy, and individuals more socially and economically responsible, rather than thinking of maximizing profits and utility for one's own sake. Solidaritists consider the consequences of all their actions, from what toothpaste they buy, to where they work, to what stocks to invest in. It assumes that individuals cannot and should not act in their own self-interest at the expense of others, as this will inevitably perpetuate the hierarchical polarization paradigm across gender, race, class, and sexual orientation, and more. The solidarity economy effort to humanize the current capitalist economy attempts to make firms more socially aware and the population more conscious of their community. Rather than purchasing to maximize their own individual utility, individuals, firms, and families should instead consider the utility of their whole community and socially responsible consumption. Many firms and organizations, both locally and nationally, have already embraced solidarity economy forms of working and producing. The critical aspect of this process is its relevance to both individuals and firms. So you may be wondering, how does one engage in more socially conscious business practices to further the solidarity economy? First, you can monitor how you work and produce. Producer co-ops, nonprofits, socially responsible and green businesses are all examples of solidaristic businesses practices. As an individual, it is also important to act as a whistleblower for non-solidaristic business practices in order to teach and progress the solidarity economy. As a consumer, it is always important to consider how you consume and all of your consumption and utility maximization affects your community, the environment, and the earth. Supporting collective consumption, green consumption, fair trade, simple living, and public goods all are solidaristic forms of consuming. When exchanging and selling goods, to keep in mind with the solidarity economy, be sure that no products are wasted by participating in freeganism, free cycling, and charity and open source. By taking and using what isn't being used and sharing with neighbors and friends, you can limit your impact on the environment. And not all forms of investment and saving are bad for our economy. Consciously investing in socially responsible businesses and keeping money deposits with socially responsible banks supports our economy in a solidaristic way.